Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler.
Hi, I'm Joni, the teardrop nanny. Today's a great day for a picnic in the park, and I'm making a special dessert for Dean, peanut butter and jelly bars.
Stay tuned.
Peanut butter and jelly bars are both free of gluten and cholesterol, as the protein comes from the peanut butter. For today's recipe, you will need some garbanzo beans, also known as chickpeas, some honey, vanilla extract, creamy peanut butter, old-fashioned rolled oats, some unsalted roasted peanuts, baking powder, baking soda, some kosher salt, and some jam. I have some sugar-free red raspberry preserves. If you have access to electricity and a food processor, you can take this 15-ounce can of garbanzo beans, once they've been drained and rinsed, and you can put them into the food processor to make them creamy. If you don't have the food processor, go ahead and put them in a bowl and mash them up as fine as you can get them. It may take you a while to break them up, but once you do, you'll go ahead and add in the honey and the vanilla. Garbanzo beans have a bit of a shell around them. It's translucent, so it sheds what looks like little skins, like little onion skins. When I see them in there, I tend to pick those out that don't get mashed up. I'll add in 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract and the honey. Once I add in the honey and the vanilla, I'll stir it around a bit, but I'm going to transfer it to a larger bowl. That way I'll be able to really whip it around to make it creamy. Then I can add in the other ingredients like the peanut butter. I transferred it to a larger bowl. I'll be adding in 1/2 cup of creamy peanut butter, stirring in and scraping the sides as necessary. I'm putting in 1/2 cup of creamy peanut butter. You might be able to use a chunkier kind, but you will be adding peanuts, which will add the chunks to it. As you mix it up, be sure and incorporate it thoroughly, scraping the sides as necessary. You want it to get it as creamy as possible. I'm going to continue to stir this in, mixing it up for a couple of minutes. At this point, your mixture will probably look a lot like hummus, which of course is made from garbanzo beans. I'll bet this would be very good spread atop some crackers. I'm going to go on now to mix in the peanuts, the rolled oats, and some of the other ingredients into a second small bowl. So I'm going to set this mixture aside, and I've smashed up any chunks that I saw in there. In the small bowl, combine 1 teaspoon of the baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. I have 1/3 cup of rolled oats. Here goes the other cup. 2/3 cup total of rolled oats. Then add in 1/2 cup of roasted unsalted peanuts, more or less. This happens to be the 1/2 cup. Mix these dry ingredients a bit together before you add them to the peanut butter mixture. Add the oat mixture to that peanut butter mixture. Stir it up first. Yes, it will be chunky. Once you have it mixed up, remove 1 cup of the dough and set aside in a bowl. That's because when you go to make this, you're going to be doing a little bit of layering, and this dough is going to be what's crumbled on top. So I'm going to take out approximately 1 cup of the dough and put it aside. I'm prepping a 10-inch Dutch oven with parchment paper, and I want the parchment paper to overlap on the sides for ease of removal. If you don't use parchment paper, you might have to put some type of a grease or oil down in order to get it out easily. Parchment paper, though, will make it come out much easier. I'll be baking this in the 10-inch oven at 350 degrees, so I'm taking from the big bowl, the dough, and I'll press it all the way around to the sides to even it out. Now that I have the dough spread out all the way around the sides, I'm going to take 1/3 of a cup, and I have some sugar-free raspberry preserves here, and I'll spread it all across the top. Start first with a dollop all around the edges, and then you can spread it out. So just kind of paint it over the peanuts. Once you have your jam spread out, take that 1 cup of dough that you set aside and add it around. It doesn't really crumble too much, but I'm going to do it in half teaspoonfuls or teaspoonfuls like this. And continue till you use up the whole cup. Once you have all that spread out, I didn't press it down. I just added enough on top to make the crumble. Also, when I was mixing in those oats, I forgot to tell you that I put in the salt at that time also with the baking powder and baking soda. I'll use 350 degrees to bake this. In a 10-inch oven, that's 21 coals, 14 on top and 7 on the bottom. Baking this at 350, the edges will just pull away from the side of the Dutch oven, and the top will be set in light golden brown. It'll be 30 to 35 minutes since this oven is not hot. Here's that 10-inch Dutch oven, 350 degrees. I have 21 coals, 14 on top, 7 on the bottom. Ones on top I arranged for 12 around the edge and the 2 in the middle. Bake it for 30 minutes. I'll check it then and see if it needs to go any longer. After 30 minutes now, I'm going to give it a check. I want the edges to just pull away from the pan, and I want the top to be set and light golden brown. Well, it definitely looks golden brown on top. And as you can see, it comes away from the edges. I'll remove it from the heat and place it on a wire rack to cool for about 15 minutes. Once this is cooled, I'll use that parchment paper overhang to transfer it to the wire rack below and let it cool completely. Once it's cooled down for about 15 minutes, use that parchment paper to help lift it out of the Dutch oven and cool it completely on a wire rack. Here's the completed peanut butter and jelly bars. I'll cut them into squares and serve them up. peanut butter, jelly, jelly. Peanut butter, jelly, jelly. Yeah.
We hope you enjoyed today's webisode.
We love to be in the woods, and these beautiful redwoods are the perfect place for the picnic. It's time for dessert, shall we? Give it a try. I got jelly in that bite.
Very peanutty. These have garbanzo beans in them?
Yes, they do.
Wow.
Adds that extra protein.
Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
Until the next time, happy trails to you. Mm-hmm.